Welcome to my blue circle.
Me and my cats want to talk to you about some things that maybe you didn't learn in your yoga class. Maybe you learned and then you forgot. Maybe you didn't learn it because there was no time. Maybe because you joined a little bit later. Or maybe you arrive always 5 or 10 minutes later, or you leave 5 or 10 minutes early. Maybe you didn't learn them because you don't come to class regularly. Maybe you change teachers often and then you don't get to stay with one yoga teacher for a long time, so you kind of miss their flow, let's say. Maybe you didn't learn it because you didn't ask. Maybe your teacher didn't say it. Maybe your teacher said it only once or mentioned it and then he or she hopes that you would remember, which is impossible, right? You cannot remember everything. Maybe because your teacher hopes you will find out for yourself. It's not your fault. It's probably not your teacher's fault. It's probably everybody's fault because there is so much information and it's normal that it passes you by.
So in each video, I want to give you just a little bit of a tiny information and to help you remember these crucial things that will help you improve your yoga practice and maybe also your everyday life.
So, the first thing that people often miss in a yoga class is the diaphragmatic breath. This is a shame because this kind of breath is crucial and fundamental to all kinds of breathings, all kinds of pranayamas, and you should even do it not only while you are practicing your asanas but throughout the whole day to help you feel, you know, balanced, relaxed and centered. What is a diaphragmatic breath? It's a abdominal breathing. It's the breathing where you actually just use the diaphragm, this part of your stomach, or actually the thin muscle that envelops the whole stomach area, right? And then you sort of expand it with the inhale and then you contract it with the exhale. At the same time, you're trying for the breath to be balanced and inhale, exhale. And to push on the exhale your belly button towards the spine. So how do we practice it? We usually put the right hand on our stomach and our left hand on our chest, and we observe how the right hand moves. With the inhale, it moves out, and with the exhale, it moves in. The left hand is usually completely still. This is the inhale, and this is the exhale. It should be as slow as possible, as calm as possible, without jitter and stops and breaks, and
if you are not doing it, start practicing 1 minute in the morning when you're still in bed, 1 minute when you're gonna sort of fall asleep just before or when you're in bed, to calm you down and to get you connected with your breath.